I've handled a lot of vehicular manslaughter cases over the course of the last 25 years. Many times the prosecutors will actually file a murder case against the person and try and put them away for a very, very long time. Obviously, I have battled many situations like that, gone through the jury instructions, and really have a feel for what the jurors are going to be looking at in a particular case in deciding whether or not it's a murder case versus a vehicular manslaughter case. Really kind of what it boils down to is, did the person who was driving act in a wanton or gross disregard for human life? In other words, did they have a feel if they drank or if they sped real fast that it could end in a death? And if the answer is yes, they're going to get convicted of murder, because being able to prove that, the prosecutors can prove the malice they need for murder. If, on the other hand, the person was careless, wasn't thinking, just made a stupid move, that cost somebody their lives tragically, that's a situation that can be argued for a manslaughter, and the manslaughter sentencing is obviously much easier, and the person actually can get out and have a life after that. So it's a huge difference. I would suggest, give me a call, set up a consultation, we can sit down, and I can tell you, when you leave my office, you will have a feel as it relates to your particular case or your loved one's particular case. You'll have a feel for kind of what you're up against, what we need to prove, and what we can do to get the best possible result for the case.